page 138, spreadsheet skills to provide management accounting information. I've already set up my page, and if you've watched my previous videos, you'll see that this is how I like to work. Now, if you haven't watched the videos, I like to go to view. From view, I like to go to new window and then arrange all vertical. Then on the left, I'll have my instructions, and on the right, I'll have my spreadsheet. So, situation. Beautiful Tableware Limited has been operating for many years and produces stoneware dishes for cooking and serving food in. Your manager, Claire, has set up a template for the overhead absorption rates for next year. She's asked you to complete the calculations and has given you the raw data and costs in a spreadsheet. You've been asked to save the spreadsheet file in the appropriate location and rename it as MATST CH4 Spreadsheet Case Study Beautiful Tableware Answer. So you will go File Save As, go to where you want to save it, and then make sure you call it exactly how it says on the spreadsheet. If you close the file down, make sure you reopen the file that you've just saved. And now we're ready to start. You are required to, in the worksheet called Apportionment for Calculation, which is this tab here, use the lookup function and absolute cell referencing to find the values for the basis of apportionment and the table of F6 to K10. The basis of apportionment is on the worksheet called Basis of Apportionment. So, this is where I want to put in my formula. But I need to decide, is it a V lookup or a H lookup? Firstly, always look at your data. As you can see, this is a vertical data, so it will be the V lookup that I will be doing. And I want to make sure that the heading that I'm looking for will be what's in the first column, or the column that I'm looking in. In my case, it's floor space, number of employees, value of machinery, which is in column B. So I want to go to formulas, insert function, V lookup. The first one is, what am I looking for? Well, I'm looking for floor space. Now I want to put a dollar sign at the beginning of B, not in between B6. If I put it in B6 as well as at the beginning of B, I'm locking the cell, and I don't want to lock the cell because when I replicate down, it will change from B6 to B7, B7 to B8, etc. Now the table array is, where am I looking for it? We know it's in basis of apportionment. So I'm going to go to table array, and I'm going to click on basis of apportionment. I'm going to highlight the data that I want, so from floor space all the way across till I've got all the data selected. Please make sure that you do put the dollar signs between the A and the A4, the G and the G6. The reason being is when I replicate down, I want that data to stay, and I don't want it to go down onto the next cell. So I want to lock in from A4 to G6. As this information is in column 2, I'm going to say look up column 2, and I'm going to say false, because I want to find exact. When I'm happy, I can press enter. And as you can see, it's come up 500. And what I mean by column 2, it's moulding. So this is column 1, this is column 2. When I go to glazing, I need to change the 2 to a 3. When it's finishing, 3 to a 4. Stores, 4 to a 5, etc. It is 500, and number of employees will be 5, and value of machine will be 35. So when I replicate down, I want to make sure that value of machine, we said 35,000. Yep. Floor space 500, floor space 500, and number of employees 5, which means that my formula is correct. Now, what I could do is either type the formula out again or replicate across. Remember, this is going to be in column 3, so I'll need to change the 2 to a 3. This one was 4. This one was 5. This one was 6. And if you're not sure, just go and check it. So 500, 150, 150, 25. 500, 150, 150, 25, which is brilliant. And as it's got the total, and as you can see, I've got total here, but it doesn't say the word total. But if I was to add that up, that does make it 825. I could replicate that across and change number 6 to number 7. Oops, wrong one. To number 7. Now that I've done all the data that I needed, I can replicate down. And it looks like I've taken the line away, so I'm just going to quickly put the line back in because you don't want to distort any other data. So I'm just going to the font and I'm looking for right border. There we go. It's now saying apportion the total costs in the apportionment table, which is down here. Use the appropriate calculation formula and link the data from the apportionment basis table using absolute cell reference. If you've been taught this topic, you will know that you will need to enter a formula. And the way I've taught my learners is your total, which is this one here, divided by their total, and as it's floor space, I need to make sure I use floor space, divided by whatever, which is the moulding. Now, as I want your total to be stagnant or fixed, I'm going to put dollar signs manually around E15 and K6. But I'm not doing it to F6 because I want, when I replicate down or across, I want it to move accordingly. So now, I can replicate across. Something's gone wrong. Let's do that again. So, equals open brackets. Your total divided by their total times by moulding 500. Yes, looks better. So now I'm just going to put the dollar signs in, as I said earlier. That's much better. Now if I replicate across, I need to add these up, and if it comes to 3,300, I know my formula is correct. So let me just make this smaller, and I can replicate down, saves me having to do everything all over again. So, I will need to change my cells because I want to change that to 16. And that to 7. If I was to take the middle dollar signs out, just to speed things up, and replicate across, I'm hoping that when I put a sum, it should give me 3,300. So let's have a look. Formulas, auto sum. I don't want to include that, so I'm just going to reduce it to F15 to J15. And it's giving me 3,300, which means my formulas are all correct. And I can check that every single one of them are giving me the right totals, which is excellent. And it says I need to do a sum to this one as well. Just to cross-reference. And it is exact, so that's perfect. It says use an if statement in L15. So L15 is this one here, to compare the total in E15 to be calculated cost in K15, showing OK if it's correct and error if it's not. So I'm going to click on insert function, if, and I'm going to say if this total equals this total, then I want you to say OK. Otherwise, I want you to say error. gone on there. So let's do it again. If this total equals to that total, then I want to say OK. Otherwise, I want to say error. As I know, these two are the same, so I'm expecting OK to come up. And then I can replicate down. It's now saying we need to apportion the stores and maintenance costs using the direct method and enter the following information. So I want to apportion stores. This is stores, and as you can see, it's on the row of stores. Now, when I'm apportioning it using the direct method, I want the 4,400 to come up as a negative. So I'm going to go equals minus and link by clicking on I21. You'll see that that's come up as a minus. And I want to apportion it so moulding gets 60%. So I'm going to go equals open brackets. 4,400 multiplied by 60%, close brackets. I could replicate across, but I'll need to make sure I put a dollar sign on the I21. Now, when I replicate across, everything's going to be 60%, but I don't want it to be 60%, so I'll need to change glazing to 30%, and I'll need to change finishing to 10%. It says format E15 to K25. So E15 is here to K25, which is there, to pound signs, two decimal places with thousand separators. So right click format cells, currency, two decimal places, pound sign. Going to go to number, thousand separator, and OK. Now, don't worry if you've got the hashes. It just means the column's not big enough, so you'll just need to make sure you amend that, as all data should be fully visible. I now need to do maintenance. I'm just going to do exactly the same, equals minus J21. And I want that to be 75% of 3,700. So I'm going to go J21. Now you don't need to put the dollar signs in, but I like to speed things up. So by putting the dollar signs in, it makes my life a little bit easier. 75%. The next one should be 15%, so I'm going to change the 75 to 15, and the last one should be 10%, so I'm changing that. We now need to do the overhead absorption rates on machine hours for moulding and glazing, and labour is for finishing. So overhead absorption rate is money divided by activity, and these are the activities. So for molding, we're going to be using machine hours, so I'm going to go equals open brackets the money divided by the machine hours, which is 25,380, and enter. That gives me £2.09. I need molding and glazing to be for finishing. Sorry, let's do that again. So machine hours for molding and glazing. So machine hours for molding and glazing. So that's this divided by 3,865. And then I want finishing to be labour hours. So equals open brackets money divided by 1,232, close brackets. And that's £8. It says calculate the overhead absorption rate for the correct F27, G27, G27 and H27. And it wants us to use the roundup to the nearest penny and format to currency. Well, I've done the formula already, but I want to round up. So I'm just going to type in round up. And after the 25380, as I want it two decimal places, I'm going to say to 2. Enter. I need to do the same here. So before the bracket, round up. After the 3865, but before the bracket, comma, 2 to 2 decimal places. And again here. Comma, 2 decimal places. It says, amend the column width to ensure the descriptions and data can be viewed. Well, I've already done that, but if you look, B's not amended. Quicker way is to go into the magic triangle, double click, and it should update all your data, but in this case it hasn't. So I'm just going to amend each one. Everything looks visible. Make the title apportionment with the pound sign bold. So you could go home, bold, by clicking on the B or control B. Hide column E, so this one I want to hide, right click, hide. And there we have it. This task is now complete.